Hi everyone! This video has been a long time coming, but finally here is the time lapse of the very first painting in my Opera Moth series. If you have been following my process with this series on Twitch, you will know that I started working on this painting in 2020, just before the Victorian Animals exhibition. So while that was on, I took a break from this Opera Moths project. This meant that the Seamstress Moth painting was not finished until October 2021, and I am now working on three other paintings in the series. I estimate that I took around 216 hours to complete this painting over the course of the year. This was also while I worked on other projects and started other paintings in the series. If you would like to support my art journey, learn a little bit more about each painting as I am working on my research, get early access to new videos, exclusive art prints and more, pop on over to patreon.com/squibble. Also, on Mondays and Tuesdays from 1 to 5pm NZST, I work on my oil paintings for this series over on Twitch, so if you'd like to drop in and see my progress, please come and say hi. Moth paintings are a follow-up to my 2020 Victorian Animals series. Each painting explores the world of moths living and working at the Paris Opera House, or Palais Garnier, in the late 1800s. Each of the paintings will focus on a particular moth or group of moths working on a task in or around the theatre. I have planned 10 oil paintings in this series, along with extra ink drawings and maybe a few watercolours. I am hoping that I will be able to have another exhibition with these paintings, and I am aiming for a completion date of mid-2024. At this point, you might be asking, why moths? After I'd had a bit of a break after the Victorian Animal Family exhibition, I started thinking about the characters again. What were they doing? Where had they ended up and how did they get there? One character I kept thinking about was Mr. Tawny Frogmouth, an Australian nightjar that somehow made it to Paris. The description for his portrait states that he is standing under a streetlight after leaving a performance at the Palais Garnier. At about the same time, I was researching moths and discovered that there are hundreds of very beautiful and extremely fluffy moths. I started drawing them and realised that the combination of moths with nightjars or owls could make a very interesting story. Thank you. working on the paintings, so I don't want to reveal the whole story arc for the series just yet. However, I will be exploring a little part of the opera moth's world in each painting. For this painting is based on the real costume room in the Palais Garnier. I think of the spaces that the moths inhabit as miniature versions of the real thing. Perhaps they are tucked away in the walls and under the floors of the opera house. They live and work adjacent to the human theatre world. Seamstress moth is a clothes moth, and when I was designing her, I combined the look of two different types of clothes moths. I particularly like the look of the common clothes moth with its fluffy head, and I wanted to incorporate the fluff into a sort of upswept hairdo for my character. Initially, the idea was to have Miss Seamstress Moth biting the thread to cut it, but as I was creating the concept sketches for the character, I discovered that the adult clothes moths actually have no mouths and cannot eat. I went off and did some more research and introduced her small larva friend to the painting. The larva is her assistant and is able to bite and cut the thread for her. I'd like to talk a bit about my painting process, although I have shared videos before showing my process from start to finish. I normally start all my oil paintings with an underpainting in raw umber to create a value painting. I also add quite a bit of detail at this stage, which naturally takes a lot of time. But all of the extra planning at this stage saves time later on and makes the rest of the painting process go very smoothly. After I have completed the underpainting, I then start to add very thin glaze layers of colour one by one. Each of these colour layers takes about 24 to 48 hours to dry, sometimes a little longer. I also start to add more detail and colour as I go, building more depth into the painting. Once I have added all the detail that I want and the colours are looking vibrant, it's time to varnish the painting. For varnishing, I use a brush that I reserve only for this purpose. The varnish I use is Gamvar by Gamblin. I add one thin layer of varnish at a time and let it dry, then come back to the painting the next day and add another layer. For most of my paintings, I add three or four layers of varnish in total. And here is the varnished painting. I am very happy with this, it looks so great. What? Where is the signature? I forgot to add my signature. There's no need to panic though. The varnish is super easy to remove and we will take this opportunity to show how you can remove the varnish on your painting. For this process, I'm using Gamsol by Gamblin. I'm using just a little bit of it on a cotton swab to gently dissolve the varnish. Then I use a small piece of lint-free cloth to rub the waste away from the surface. In this case, I had a small scrap of linen that I used. There we go, as easy as that. It looks like the smallest bit of pigment did lift up, but that has not made any difference to the painting, and once this corner is revarnished, you won't be able to tell. And here we are revarnishing the corner of the painting. Thank you. finally, after well over 216 hours, here is the finished painting. I hope you enjoyed this peek into my process from start to finish. Please let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. I painted this piece live over on my Twitch channel, so I will leave a link to it in the description below if you would like to drop in and see the other opera moth paintings I am working on at the moment. Thank you also to my patrons, with whom I have been sharing behind the scenes updates on my progress and extra opera moth concept art pieces. Thanks for watching this video, and I will be back again soon with more art fun. Have a great day, everyone, and see you next time!